I'm here at the Trinity Boxing Club in Los Angeles. They have a branch in New York, and one thing that makes this gym unique are the signs on the wall. Martin Snow, your gym here. Tell me about some of the signs you got here.
Well, I'm big into inspirational quotes. I like to get people motivated and fired up when they box. So I'll take you around and show you some my favorites. Right over here, one of my all-time favorites. Everybody wants to go to heaven, but nobody wants to die.
Ain't that the truth? Everybody wants to go to heaven, nobody wants to die.
I believe so.
How does that relate to boxing?
I have no idea, but it sounds good.
No, everybody wants to win, but not everybody wants to put in the work.
Right. Yeah, well, everybody wants the payoff, but you gotta go through a little hell to get there.
Okay, what's the next sign you got?
One of my all-time favorites, when you come to the fork in the road, take it.
What does that mean, when you come to the fork in the road?
I have no idea.
But you like it.
I like it, it sounds good. You know, Yogi Berra wasn't the brightest guy in the world, but he was very insightful.
Go with your instinct, don't wait, don't hesitate, just take it.
Go with your instinct, yeah. Hey, come to the fork and I'm going to take it.
You know, people are going to watch this video and say, this guy puts up signs.
That he doesn't know what they mean. But it never stopped me before.
But it's inspirational signs. Let's see another one.
Yeah, as long as they inspire other people, I'm not the smartest guy in the world either. One of my idols, Babe Ruth, never let the fear of striking out get in your way. Swing and swing big.
Go for it.
Go for it. If you're going to swing the bat, swing big.
If you get in the ring, throw some punches.
Go for it. You got to be a tiger.
Go for the knockout.
Exactly. You got to be a tiger. Now, here's another one. Almost my motto, fortune favors the bold. Virgil.
You got to be brave.
Everybody, you have to take chances in life. You got to take risks in life. You got to take chances. That's why I'm looking forward to this fight, Peter Quillen versus Andy Lee. You got to roll the dice.
Ireland
against Brooklyn. Take, you know, fight for the fans. Don't fight for yourself. Fight for the fans. This is a great fight for boxing. We want to be a good advertisement for boxing, and this is it.
I see the Irish flag right over there on the wall.
Yes, I am Irish.
You're Irish, but you're going to go in this fight with Peter Quillen.
I got to go with Quillen. Well, he's also Irish. People don't know this about Pete. Yeah, he's part Irish also. The Quillen name is Irish.
The Grand Rapids chapter.
Yeah, I don't know exactly how much Irish. I think it's like 10% Irish. And another great quote over here, 16 years of Catholic school.
Okay.
I have fought the good fight. I have finished the course. I have kept the faith. So
that's a very, very famous, very famous quote.
And a very famous quote. St. Paul to Timothy wrote the letter to Timothy.
Marquez, Pacquiao, Cotto.
I mean, I think Pacquiao has to fight Marquez again. But I mean, the fight everybody wants to see Pacquiao Mayweather.
Oh, absolutely. You're right.
You know, that has to happen. Whatever, you know, that's a fight that has to happen. And then I'll show you another one of my all-time favorite quotes right back here. Everyone's got a game plan till they get punched in the face. And that pretty much sums up life, you know? Everybody's got a plan.
By the great Mike Tyson. Mike.
Yeah, he is like the Socrates of his day.
Did you know him? Because he's from New York and you're from New York.
I met Tyson a couple of times. He filmed a movie at the gym once, and then he trained with Customato, and I was out of the Gramercy gym in New York, so I met him up there. Very nice guy. I also bumped into him up at a Giorgio Armani one time.
and cool dude?
A real cool dude. He was walking by, and he just stopped and turned around. He goes, "Hey, and you from Brooklyn?" I go, "Yeah, how'd you know?" He goes, "Yeah, I know." And then we talked for a little while.
What was Roberto Duran's sign over here?
Well, this is a lie. See, it says, "He who stops being better stops being good." And I didn't know who said it, so I said, "Let's attribute that to Duran."
Oh, okay.
He never said that, though. I just made that up.
But it sounds good.
It sounded good, but, you know, I didn't know who said it. So it sounds better.
Mayweather says hard work and dedication. Would that ever make a billboard?
I doubt that.
No.
Very much. yeah, I don't think we'll put any. How about you? Come on, we're doing an interview. Where are you from?
I'm from Yellow Book, Yellow Pages.
Come right over here. We got to interview you.
Yellow Book? You gonna put the gym in a book?
That was my thought process.
The great Ellie Seaback. What's your name?
Hey, how are you?
I'm Stan Red.
Hey, Stan. Nice to meet you. Yeah. Are you a boxing fan?
Yes, I am.
Who's your favorite fighter?
Who do you think? Come on, take a small guess. He's in the middleweight class and he called somebody a punk.
Kid Chocolate.
No, he just said Floyd Mayweather. Who called him that guy?
He's not a middleweight, though. He's a
welterweight.
Welterweight. Yeah, but he did call Manny a punk. How do you know about that? Are you on Facebook, on Twitter?
You know, no. 7:10. What's the one that comes on at 10 o'clock from 10 to 1 o'clock?
Max Kellerman and Marcellus Wiley.
That's all I'm talking about, okay?
Marcellus is a cool dude. Yeah. Max is okay.
Yeah.
Look at this sign right over here.
Okay, which one?
A champion is someone who gets up when he can't.
Jack Dempsey is my favorite fighter.
Did he really say that?
He said that, okay. Yeah. Jack Dempsey said that one. He was my favorite fighter. I have to say, my favorite fighters of all time, I gotta go with Dempsey, Tunney, Roberto Duran, Sugar Ray Leonard. My favorite fighters, great champions. I think Sugar Ray Leonard would knock out any welterweight in the world today. Hi, come on up.
You got everybody here coming to you. You got Yellow Pages, you got Shoeshine.
Yeah, pretty much. I've never seen sneakers and shine before. You actually shine sneakers?
Let me see. Well, yeah, I can shine them with the regular cream.
Stay tuned for more for EsNewsReporting.com with Melly Secback reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter, @Secback.